हेलो फ्रेंड्स, वेलकम टू अरुण ज्योत चैनल यथा सूर्यास तथा ज्ञानम। आई एम रुचि। इन द पार्ट वन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7 एक्सपेरिमेंट्स विथ वाटर, वी हैव डन सम अमेजिंग एक्सपेरिमेंट्स विथ वाटर एंड आई एम श्योर दैट यू ऑल मस्ट हैव एंजॉयड इट। इफ यू हैव मिस्ड दोज लर्निंग्स देन प्लीज वॉच पार्ट वन ऑफ चैप्टर नंबर 7। Also like and share this video. Please don't forget to subscribe my channel Arun Jyot. Uske paas wala bell icon dabana mat bhuliyega so that you get regular notification of my each and every video. Today also we will learn new things with some more experiments with water. But before that, let's have a look at the poem which is given in your textbook at page number 61. The title of the poem is Why, Oh Why. A wooden boat in water will float, but a needle will sink. Why does this happen? Let me think. An iron ship will also float, though it's much heavier than my boat. But a needle, light as a leaf, thin as a pin, will sink right in. Why did this happen? Let me think. So this was the interesting poem Why, So Why, which arises many questions and many doubts regarding which things floats and which things sinks in water. In the previous part itself, I have solved most of your doubts with the help of examples and with the help of mass and volume examples. So I hope that everything is clear to you. Now, let's have some magic with Aisha. Aisha's ammi had fever. Her abbu made some tea and went to give medicines to her. He told Aisha to boil 2 eggs and add some salt in it. But by mistake, Aisha put too much salt in water. She observed that the eggs which were at the bottom of the pan came up and started floating in water. Same thing happens if you put lemon in too much of salty water. What do you think that why lemon and eggs floats in too much of salty water? Let's solve this puzzle. Have you heard about Dead Sea? All oceans and seas have salty water, but the saltiest among all is the Dead Sea. It is located between Israel and Jordan. You can see in the map how much salty it is. Imagine 300 grams of sugar in 1 liter of water. That much salty it is. But that's make it super magical. How? Even if a person doesn't know how to swim, he or she will not drown in the sea. She will float in water as if lying down on it. So now you can understand that why lemon and eggs float in too much of salty water. Isn't it interesting? So if we are talking about salt, let us all educate ourselves with the important page of Indian history, the Dandi March. You must be familiar with this term, but if you haven't, let me take you when this incident happened. This was the time when India was under British rule. For many years, British had made the law which does not allow people to make salt by themselves. They had levied a heavy tax on salt. Salt is must an important part of our food. How can one live without salt? To this, Mahatma Gandhiji said, "How can the law does not allow us to use the thing which the nature has given to us?" So Gandhiji with several other people went on to a yatra from Ahmedabad to Dandi seashore in Gujarat, which was 386 kilometers long walk, to protest against this law. The world took note of this iconic salt march led by Mahatma Gandhiji. Even Time magazine put Gandhiji on its front cover, which was issued on January 4, 1931 as Man of the Year. Because of this incredible success of the Satyagraha, British government had to abolish the salt law. And after that, people are allowed to make salt by themselves without giving any tax to the British government. But this arises a question that how salt is prepared. The seawater is collected in the shallow beds dug in the sand. The water is allowed to get dried in the sun. When the water gets dried, what remains in the ground is the salt, and this is how the special ingredient of our food, salt, is prepared. So I hope that you enjoyed this beautiful learnings, and we will meet in the next video. Till then, bye-bye, take care, namaste, stay healthy, stay safe, and most importantly, stay happy.